students, in this video we will be talking about the writing section of English, which is a very important section for your personal growth, for improving your vocabulary, for enhancing your imagination power, and for you yourself expressing your own emotions. Writing section is very important for your personal growth. Now, this writing section can include various topics such as letter writing, notice writing or message writing, article writing, for making posters, for advertisement, and even a topic includes diary entry. So today in this particular video, we will be discussing about diary entry. Now, diary entry is nothing but just a simple writing on your behalf about some kind of event or some kind of discussions that you make with your diary. Maybe because you're happy, you're sad, you're angry, you're disappointed due to any event that may occur in your life. Now, diary entry is not that important from the real life view of point, but in examinations, diary entry comes as a topic just in order to check your creativity, to show so that you can the teachers can understand how imaginative you are, and also the way in which you can express yourself. So diary entry is used to test your imagination. Your creativity. Or expressions, the way you express, the way you have your imaginations or your creativity, all that can be expressed through diary entry. Now, there are no hard and fast rules for writing a diary. It is just your emotions that you convey by writing, but there are rules, some rules for writing diary entry. Those rules are that first you have to mention the day, then you have to mention the date on which you are writing your diary, and next you have to mention the time at which you have marked your entry in your diary. So day, date and time on the top left corner of your page. The top left corner will include date and time. Then you will leave a line over here, and then you will say, "Dear diary." Okay, no underlining is required, just you will say, "Dear diary," and then begin with your introduction and whatever you want, right? Now, this letter, this diary writing is informal. Nothing formality is required. It is just like you speak to yourself, same way you can speak to your diary. So, no formal writing is required in diary entry. Informal things can be written the way you speak to your friend, the same way you can speak to your diary. But again, there are some important points which you need to remember while writing your diary. First thing is that if you not write in your diary every day, write points to avoid, or I can say points to remember as well. The first point to remember is that do not write every day. We are just required to write when something extraordinary happens in our life. For example, we can show our happiness, we can show disappointment, or anger issues, right? We can write a bio sketch in our diary entry, or we can pen someone's bio, Like suppose you have met a person who was a stranger, then something happened over there, maybe you helped that stranger cross the road and today you felt that this was an achievement because the good side of your emotions came out and you are happy that you are such a person, you were so happy that you helped that person. So that person's bio, the appearance of that person and how you felt about that person by helping the person, so that all can include in your diary entry. Then again, you can include points. Not to include is that do not mention weather or railway timetable. Or other common things. Diary entry is meant for remembering something which was through which you were mesmerized, the memories which you want to hold, all those are written in your diary entry. But just like a common situation, like today mom baked a cake for me, today I went to tuition, that is not required in your diary entry. It is just for something which is extraordinary happening in your life. So, these were some of the points that you should remember while writing your diary. And this was the format. Now, let us understand that how you should write your diary through an example. So, the example that I will be discussing with you over here is the same example which is provided in the content section. So, if you want to take a deep look at the answer, then go and visit the content section over there. When you click on diary entry, the same question along with a detailed answer will be provided over there. So, now the question over here says that you paid a visit to an orphanage and old home with NSS volunteers. Now, you have to make a diary entry on the same. Along with that, there are some hints which are provided. The hint says that there is an orphanage and old home. There are young children, infants, mostly senior citizens above 60, spacious, clean, regular med checkup means medical checkup, library, nurses for children, and then the last hint is that swings are also provided. So on the basis of this, you have to make a diary entry. Now here we are clear that they are talking about old homes and orphanage, and then this is a topic of culture, this is a topic of our society, and then we have to place some points of our own, that how did you feel when you went over there, and what are your views on orphanage, what are your views on old homes. So here we have to make a diary entry on the same topic. Now, as we've already discussed the format of diary entry, here you can mention the name or you can mention the place where you went. So here the place can be Bhiwadi. And then next we have to mention the date where the date at which we went over there. So date can be anything like 10th January 2000 and whatever is the year, right? And not only do we have to mention the date, we also have to mention the day on which we are writing. So let us say that we went on Sunday because Sunday is off, and that's why with NSS volunteers we are visiting on a weekend. So Sunday, and then at what time? Time can be 11 a.m. right? Whenever we are mentioning time, we also have to keep in mind about how you are writing your diary, right? Basically, if I am talking about 11 a.m., diaries are meant to be written at night generally. So, I can say that I am writing my diary at 9 p.m., right? This can be my format of writing diary. Then again, next I will say dear diary. Why? Because I'm talking to my diary, and after dear diary, I have to begin with writing a diary, right? Now I'm talking about old age, old homes and orphanage. So I say that I felt disheartened today seeing that our generation has become stone-hearted and they do not care to look after their parents at their when I say at their growing age, or instead of growing, I can also say at their old ages. Right? Here I have talked about the society, how today's society has been, right? So you will say that I visited orphanage and old age home today. Right? So you've said that. Then you can talk about that, what all you saw. That you saw young children, also the infants were present over there. Maybe the parents could not take care of their children because of poverty, or maybe there can be something very tragic that could have happened with the parents, because of which the children are now orphans, and that's why they are staying over there. So you can also talk about that. Mostly there were senior citizens which were present over there, and looking at their appearance, I can easily make out that they were above 60. Then you can also talk about the area, that the area was very clean, it was very spacious. Plus, so the children can educate themselves well, and even the old people do not feel bored. There was a big library that was present, and enough books were present for them. There were a lot of categories of books. There were fictions and all that you can explain over there. Then you can also say that there is a doctor appointed in the place who visits the orphanage, or you can say who visit the old home twice a week. Then you can talk about children, that children are taken care of over there. There's special teachers who educate the children, right? Then in the evening, the children are allowed to go to the swings. So something like that, you can cook up your own story. Even if the hints are not provided, we know that what happens in an orphanage, what happens in old home, why the children are living over there, why old people are living over there. So bring about the ideas of your own in order to write a diary. Make sure that you end the diary very well. Like you can say that I pledge to take care of my parents when they go old, when they grow old. I'll never let them stay in such old homes, no matter what, right? And then you can say that, okay, now my mother is calling me for dinner, or my father is calling me for some work, so I have to go for now. See you later. So here, you can say see you later, or you can say laters, and then yours, and then you have to mention your name over here. And this is how we can end our diary entry. Make sure that whatever you write over here is very relevant. It should not be very formal. It is an informal way. As you're talking to your friend, the same way you have to talk to your diary. And you just have to bring your heart out and write whatever you're feeling personally. So make sure that you connect to that, and keep learning and keep practicing.